Shout out to Blue Blood Sports TV.
Watching Blue Blood Sports TV.
Shout out to Blue Blood Sports TV.
Hi, you're watching Blue Blood Sports TV. Hola, está viendo Blue Blood Deporte TV.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV. So I want to talk about this rumor circling throughout the boxing community. It's going around real thick, you know. It's yet to be finalized, but it's being talked about throughout the boxing social sites such as YouTube, Facebook, you know, things of that sort, you know. And the rumor is Adrian Broner is going to be taking on Omar Figueroa. This is a tough fight, you know. This is a very good fight, you know. Omar Figueroa coming in 27-0 with 19 knockouts. He looked real good against Robert Guerrero, man. He straight destroyed Robert Guerrero. So, you know, he looked real impressive in his last fight with Robert Guerrero, man. And Adrian Broner, you know, people probably don't remember, Adrian Broner had a long-lasting feud with Robert Guerrero. You know, they never actually got in the ring and took care of that. But the way Omar Figueroa totally dismantled Robert Guerrero, man. He actually retired Robert Guerrero. And Adrian Broner, you know, he struggles with fighters such as Omar Figueroa, that style of fighting, you know, pressure fighter, come forward fighter. You know, he struggled against Adrian Granados. You know, as we saw, he lost his last fight against Mikey Garcia. He couldn't let his hands go. You know, he never took the guns out of the holster. You know, he was gun shy. You know, so this to me is a bad matchup for Adrian Broner right now. I think that he should take a different type of fight, you know, just to get in the win column, you know, get his confidence back. Because the Mikey Garcia fight, you know, he looked deflated, man. At the end of the fight, you know, he was frustrated. He was going around saying that, yeah, he took an L, and, you know, but I'm gonna come back, I'm gonna fight, and everybody that was booing me, y'all still gonna watch again, you know, y'all gonna pay to see me, you know, out of frustration, man. Kind of like a sore loser type of mentality, you know. So, you know, he talked a lot, build up the Mikey Garcia fight, man, but he never let his hands go. He never, like I said, he never got the guns out of the holster, and Mikey Garcia teed off on him, man, you know. So how Floyd say it, you make a mistake, you have to pay, you know. So Mikey Garcia made him pay for not pulling the guns out the holster, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, what could I say, man? And against Adrian Granados, against Marcos Maidana, against Sean Porter, pressure fighters, man. You just see that that style is all wrong for Adrian Broner. He just can't adapt to that style, man. He has that style just troubles him. You know, Mikey Garcia was using that style in somewhat, but he was mixing it up and he confused Adrian Broner because he was using a pressure style and then he would go into a boxing mode. You know, then he would go into counterpunch mode. So he confused the hell out of Adrian Broner. And in that fight, you know, Adrian Broner just couldn't let his hands go. I don't know if that was due to age. You know, that could be wear and tear. Sometimes when fighters just wear down, man, they just can't let their hands go as they age. They just don't have the... And Adrian Broner is not that old. You know, I'm not saying that he's old, but, you know, when you in a... Adrian Broner is not a fighter, you know. A lot of people get on Adrian Broner case for the outside of the ring antics, you know. But the bottom line is, Adrian Broner takes on all opponents, man. He don't duck and dodge nobody, you know. He fights any and everybody, you know. I never seen this guy. He does exactly what we ask of all boxers, you know. We want boxers. We want the best to fight the best, you know. I mean, he takes a lot. I can't say he took a lot of losses because he only has 3 losses, you know. But and I want to say in all 3 of his biggest fights, the Sean Porter fight, he came up short, he lost that fight, and he couldn't let his hands go. All the big fights, to me, he just don't let his hands go, you know, except for the Maidana fight, man. In the Maidana fight, he came on, he was letting his hands go, but he, you know, we saw what happened, man. He got dropped twice, you know. So I think that makes him gunshy because he got dropped twice. So it's probably in the back of his mind. Sometimes when you get dropped like that, you don't want to let your hands go because you get counted. So, you know, I'm thinking that's part of the problem with Adrian Broner, especially when he's in his big fight, Sean Porter fight. He didn't let his hands go into the last round, and that's when he dropped Sean Porter with a check hook. You know, the Marcos Maidana fight, he made Marcos Maidana. Everybody laughs at him. You know, Marcos Maidana, they say they beat the hell out of him, but that was actually a war if you go back and watch that fight, you know. He was letting his hands go in that fight, man. That was an action-packed fight. he hurt Madonna a few times, you know. And Madonna even admitted after the Mayweather fight, he said the hardest fight he had up to date was the Adrian Broner fight. He said he was the toughest opponent, the strongest opponent. So, you know, when he let his hands go, man, he's very entertaining, man. But, you know, when a fighter gets knocked down like that, you know, they get skeptical and they it's hard for them to get the guns out the holster. So I think that's part of the problem. So we saw that against Sean Porter. In the 12th round, he let his hands go. He dropped Sean Porter. You know, against Mikey Garcia, he never let his hands go. And when he did, he was backing Mikey Garcia up and had Mikey Garcia on the defense. But in that fight, you know, he never really looked like he showed up. You know, his game plan was to try and outbox Mikey Garcia, which, you know, in the first round, he looked pretty good. But then he just wasn't letting his hands go enough to win the fight, you know. And Adrian Granados, he let his hands go. But Adrian Granados being a tough journeyman, you know, he never hurt Adrian Granados. He never could, you know, stop him from coming forward. So, but he pulled that fight out, you know. At the end of the day, he got the W versus Adrian Granados. But those type of fights are just tough fights. So, you know, Mikey Garcia, he lost. The Marcos Maidana fight, he lost. And the Sean Porter fight, he lost. You know, or due to their pressure style. You know, Mikey Garcia showed him a lot of different things. He pressured him. And then he boxed him. He confused the hell out of Adrian Broner because he thought he was a flat. I think that Adrian Broner actually underestimated Mikey Garcia. He thought that he was just a flat-footed, come-forward type of fighter. But Mikey Garcia showed him a lot in that fight. He showed him a lot of different looks, you know, a lot of different angles. And I think that confused the hell out of Adrian Broner, like I said. And he just could never let his hands go. That being said, you know, I think that this fight with Omar Figueroa is all wrong for Adrian Broner right now. I think that Adrian Broner has another bad loss. It's pretty much over for Adrian Broner. He would be the gatekeeper, you know. And no disrespect to these fighters, but, you know, Demarcus Corley, Zab Judah, certain fighters, you know, they just become the gatekeeper. And when I say the gatekeeper, they become a measuring stick. And to see if, you know, they somewhere in between. They're not the lead of the elite anymore, but they're not actually B fighters, so they're somewhere in between. So they're a measuring stick for prospects and up and coming fighters to see how they actually do with in a action packed fight and a super fight under the lights where the lights are bright. You know, it's just enough to let us know, a barometer stick to let us know where this fighter stand, if he really the good, you know. Hey, and I think if Adrian Broner doesn't look good against Omar Figueroa, I actually think that's what could happen to Adrian Broner, man. A lot of people are not. I think Adrian Broner no longer wants to be the best, the greatest fighter in the world. I think that ship sailed for him, you know. In that mindset, I don't think that's the mindset. I think he's actually just, you know, he's just fighting and getting money at this point in time. You know, it's all about money now. I don't think he's actually looking to build a legacy anymore, even though he's only lost 3 fights. But, and that's due to Floyd Mayweather, man. Floyd Mayweather created this persona and the importance of the O. You know, Floyd Mayweather created that, the importance of the O. You know, back in the days, the O wasn't so important as it is today's time with today's boxers, man. So many boxers today's time are afraid to lose the O, and I think that Floyd Mayweather was the one that created that persona. And Adrian Broner, being in Floyd Mayweather's, you know, wanting to be Floyd Mayweather, I don't want to say in the shadow, but, you know, striving to be just like Floyd Mayweather, I think that was so important to him. When he lost that fight versus Marcos Maidana, I think he was deflated. We saw him walk out the ring. He didn't do a post-fight interview. I think that fight took a lot out of him. You know, he got a couple of big fights after that. And then when he got the fight, you know, another super fight, which was against Sean Porter, you know, he just didn't show up again. You know, I think that in another super fight, when the lights were at his brightest, he just was afraid to let his hands go. He never showed up for that fight. And, you know, he lost the fight. And then he got a third chance at it, a third crack at it, which was the fight with Mikey Garcia, another super fight. And, you know, this fight was supposed to put him back on the road to being a superstar once again, you know, being what everybody thought he was going to be. You know, once upon a time, everybody thought that he was going to be the next Floyd Mayweather. I actually personally thought that that was just too high, you know, for him. I didn't think that status, he would ever reach that status. You know, it's only one Floyd Mayweather, and that's it, man. You know, we have a tendency with sports to try and place a guy who's the next this and who's the next that. You know, in basketball, we look for the next Michael Jordan. In football, we look for the next Tom Brady or Peyton Manning or Jerry Rice, so on and so on, you know, things of that nature. Hockey, who's the next Wayne Gretzky, who's the next Barry Bonds, and that type of thing, you know, who's the next, and as a pitcher, you know, who's the next Roger Clemens, Dwight Gooden, that type of thing, you know. So, you know, I think we put him on a pedestal that was just too high. You know, people had expectations of Adrian Broner for him to be the next Floyd Mayweather, and he just couldn't live up to that, man. I think that hype also had a lot to do with him not showing up, man. I think the pressure built on this dude, man, and he just couldn't live up to the hype. So, you know, this fight with Omar Figueroa, man, if he pulls this fight off, man, it does put him, you know, keep him relevant, so to speak, you know, because if he loses this fight, man, his career is going to be on a downward spiral. Like I said, I just see him being a gatekeeper from here on out. Nobody's going to expect too much of him, you know, and it depends how he loses this fight. If he gets in this fight with Omar Figueroa and then he ends up not letting his hands go like he did in the Mikey Garcia fight, nobody's going to want to see this dude in the ring, especially with the outside of the ring antics and all everything else goes on with it. So, you know, this could be a huge fight. This is a huge fight for both fighters. You know, Omar Figueroa, man, he's 27-0, like I said, with 19 knockouts. Let's say he does something like knock Adrian Broner out, man. That's going to put him in good company, you know what I'm saying? That's going to put him in a good space. So, you know, hopefully this fight take place for the boxing community. Start 2018 off with a bang, keep it going. 2017, we had a lot of good fights, you know. So, hopefully this fight does take place, man. We can see where these dudes measure up, how they measure up, man. So, that's all I got on this topic. Until I get more information, I'll let you guys know about it, you know. So, that's all the information I got on it right now. TBC, to be continued. We'll let you know soon. TBA. All right, that's all I got for y'all. Blue Blood Sports TV. Hey, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the bell icon to get all the new notification. Make sure y'all hit that like button. Make sure y'all hit the bell icon so y'all know and get all the new information. All right, Blue Blood Sports TV. Peace.
Hey, you have just finished watching Blue Blood Sports TV. Don't forget to hit the bell icon for notifications, the like button, and most importantly, the subscribe button. See you soon.